The courtyard and gardens surrounding the manor were once a point of pride for the diligent custodians I employed. Great banquets and lavish social affairs were hosted here under the stars. Despite the expectation of propriety normally ascribed to those in our position, we mocked the stoic melancholy of the moss-covered fountains and cherubic statues, our salacious trysts half-hidden in the hedgerows, our morality slipping ever deeper into the mud. Soaked and sinking, these stone terraces and sprawling gardens were the site of long-forgotten revelry and well-remembered regret. Continue the onslaught. Destroy them all. Be wary. Triumphant pride precipitates a dizzying fall. The ground quakes. As the fiend falls, a faint hope blossoms. Advantage. Give them no quarter. Their formation is broken. Maintain the offensive.
confidence surges as the enemy crumbles. As victories mount, so too will resistance. Gone, fiend. Executed with impunity. Another one falls. Success so clearly in view. Or is it merely a trick of the light? Precision and power. Another abomination cleansed from our lands. Slowly, gently, this is how a life is taken. To the pit. Seize this momentum. Push on to the task's end. A momentary abatement. A powerful blow. A trifling victory. But a victory nonetheless. Thank you. decisive pummeling. Concentration. Great is the weapon that cuts on its own. Foolish horrors, brought low and driven into the mud. Mutation, unnatural and abhorrent. Time to perform beyond one's limits. Thank you. Remind yourself that overconfidence is a slow and insidious killer. Without tools of iron, you must rely on flesh and indefatigable purpose. Curious is the trapmaker's art, his efficacy unwitnessed by his own eyes. The maddening whine of multitudinous wings abates. Let us hope that is the end of things.
In those younger years, my home was a hive of unbridled hedonism. A roiling apiary where instinct and impulse were indulged with wild abandon. A bewitching predator slipped in amidst the swarm of tittering sycophants. Though outwardly urbane, I could sense in her a mocking thirst. Driven half mad by cloying vulgarity, I plotted to rid myself of this lurking threat in a grand display of sadistic sport. But as the moment of murder drew nigh, the gibbous moon revealed her inhuman desires in all their stultifying hideousness.
These swarming fiends carry a pernicious plague. A sickness so virulent, so insidious. It is more a curse than a mere disease.